Hi, my name's Ricky. Today I'm going to show you how to put the ultimate filament dry box in minutes, and best of all, it's not going to cost you any more than a decent roll of filament to make. Now there are four great reasons why this filament dry box is the one you need. I'll explain all of these as we go through the video. Now if you found this video through a search, then you probably already know that you need to keep your filament dry. To a greater or lesser degree, all 3D printed filaments are hygroscopic, which means that they absorb moisture. Moisture in your filaments basically leads to bad prints, so we need to stop it. As soon as I bought my 3D printer, I started looking for storage solutions that would keep my filament dry. I found quite a few good options online, but none of them quite hit the spot with what I was looking for. So what do we need? Well, you'll find all the links to everything you need in the description below, but it's not a big list.
You'll need the box, a household dehumidifier pack, a small handful of fasteners, and a small length of PTFE bowden tubing, depending on your particular setup. The other parts can be downloaded for free from the links below and 3D printed. No supports are needed, 20% infill will do, and the best way is to arrange the parts as shown here.
And if you don't have a 3D printer, why do you want a filament box?
Now make sure you print the correct parts, depending on whether you use metric or imperial fasteners. The only part that's different is the centre spigot, as it holds a nut captive, and the metric and imperial nuts have different dimensions. Everything else is designed to be used with both types of fasteners. The only tools you'll need are a couple of drills, a tape measure or a ruler, and something to do the fasteners up with.
Once you have all the parts printed, we can start assembly. Remember when I said at the beginning of this video that there are four great reasons why this box is the one you need? Well, reason number one is that this box is designed to be airtight before we even start.
It has a seal and four strong clips that are designed to keep food fresh. You don't need to add any additional tape, clips or sealant to make it work. Carefully remove one of the retaining clips from one of the short ends of the box and grab the base plate that you 3D printed. Use the aligning slots to place the plate on the end of the box in the correct position for hole alignment. Use a piece of tape if you find it difficult to hold and drill through the four larger holes with a 5mm drill bit. Don't drill the other hole for now in case you decide to have your filament feed out somewhere else. Next, take off the plate and remove the burrs with a larger drill bit or deburrer, being careful not to injure yourself. Reattach the clip and move the plate to the inside of the box and insert four of the bolts.
Next, lift your legs, grab your nuts and give them a twist, being careful not to go too tight. I'll grow up.
You only need to knit these up, not crush the parts. Note that the legs need to be assembled as shown here, as they are angled to make the box stand up straight. Next, find your main spindle and sit it inside the box as shown. You're now going to need to work out where you want your rolls to sit. The method I used was to measure all of my filament rolls to find the largest combination of outer and inner diameter and make sure there was enough headroom for anything I had. If you're not sure what I mean, then measure down 65mm or 2¾ inches from the lip at the top and draw a mark in the centre of the box. Drill the top hole in this mark and use the spindle plate to align the lower hole. If these holes aren't perfectly aligned, don't worry, it's not that important. The important bit is that the spindle sits in a place where the roll can slide on without hitting the top or sides of the box or the top of the dehumidifier pack when it's placed below it.
Now the reason why this part is a little bit tricky brings us on to the second reason as to why this filament dry box is the one you need. I went for a box that has the smallest possible internal volume that will still take a roll of filament and a dehumidifier pack. Now, the less air there is inside, the less air there is to dehumidify, and therefore the less moisture there is to take out. I did consider the options that a lot of other people have done, which is using a bigger box and putting multiple reels in it. But the problem with that is every time you want to change a reel, you're opening the box, letting more damp air in potentially. I wanted a box that would take one reel, one dehumidifier pack, and keep that same air in the box from when the reel is new till the reel is done. If you want me to look at an option that takes more than one reel of filament, drop a comment down below and I'll consider doing something in the future.
Using the spindle plate, bolt up the main spindle as shown here. Okay, so the next thing to do is to insert the centre spigot into the end of the main spindle and close the box. You want to make sure the spindle is straight here, as if it's too far off then your filament will want to slide to one side all the time. Not a massive problem, but avoid it if you can.
For those of you who want to show your appreciation of the work I put into making this dry box the best it can be, I've provided a link below in the description where you can buy me a coffee. Don't worry if not, but at least consider sharing this video with anybody you know who 3D prints. Cheers.
Looking through the lid, mark in the center of the back of the spigot. Remove the lid and drill a hole at this mark. Using the spigot cap, bolt the spigot to the lid and check that everything goes together when you reattach the lid.
The box is now sealed, which brings me on to the third reason as to why this filament dry box is the one you need. Once the box is sealed with your reel inside, there's no need to open the box until the reel is empty. This is because we're going to feed the filament out of the box using a piece of Bowden cable so that you can continue to print with the box sealed and the filament inside. Therefore, the air that you put in at the beginning gets dehumidified and stays in the box. You're not opening it all the time, letting more humidity in.
Now it's unlikely you'll want your filament to feed out the bottom like mine unless you have an enclosure like mine.
If you like the look of my 3D printer enclosure, then check out the other video on my channel where I show you how to make it and provide full build plans for free.
Decide where you want your filament to exit your box and carefully drill a hole. I've found that a 3.8mm hole is best for a tight fit on the Bowden cable, but if all you have is something bigger, just make sure you seal the gap between the outside of the cable and the box to stop any moisture getting in. Hot glue, blue tack or something more exotic will probably do the trick, but with a 3.8mm hole I barely need anything, but I'm adding a little contact adhesive just to stop it sliding out. Alternatively, you can fit a Bowden cable connector, but I'm trying to keep this project as simple as possible so everyone can make it. Your filament dry box is now built. It's time to load your reel, feed through your filament, pop in a pack and close the lid.
This brings me on to the fourth and final key feature of this filament dry box. These dehumidifier packs. These packs are designed to dehumidify very large spaces like rooms, caravans, garages. The tiny little volume of air that we're giving it is no problem.
The desiccant crystals not only soak up a huge amount of moisture, but deposit anything they collect in the chamber below and keep on drawing out moisture until the chamber is full, rather than getting soaked and sitting there all damp and useless until they're removed and dried in an oven. So just how good is this setup at removing the moisture from the air? Take a look at this time lapse to see just how much the relative moisture content in the air inside the box decreases.
I actually surprised myself by how good this box is, considering it's completely passive, uses no energy, uses no heat, uses nothing else to dry the air other than one of these standard household dehumidifier packs. So what do these figures mean and how can we compare them? In every video I've seen so far, everybody uses these little hygrometers, which is what I've used in my test. But the only problem is, they only show relative humidity, not absolute humidity. What's the difference? Well, relative humidity is how humid the air is relative to the pressure and temperature. Absolute humidity is how much moisture there actually is in any given volume of air. If you just go off these figures, you're going to be kidding yourself, because all you need to do is warm everything up and the air gets less humid, relatively. This is because warm air holds more moisture than cold air. Now you don't need to get into all the science of that, just make sure you calculate the figure you get from these to get to your absolute humidity when doing any kind of comparisons. So now we know what we're looking for, let's go back to our results. If we look at the results of our test 24 hours later, these are the figures we have. Outside the box is 11.6 degrees centigrade with a relative humidity of 75%. Inside the box is 11.5 degrees centigrade with a relative humidity of 26%. I find the Mitchell Instruments online calculator to be the easiest to use, and I've linked to it in the description. Here are the two results side by side. The easiest to understand metric for me is the absolute humidity reading. Outside our box, we have the equivalent of 7.8 grams per meter cubed of air. Inside the box, we have only 2.7 grams for the same volume. That's a 65% reduction in humidity.
It's also worth noting the 14 degree reduction in dew point.
The next best option I could find online was 18% humidity at a temperature of 28.7 degrees. Now, if we plug those figures into our online calculator, we can see that we have an absolute humidity of 5 grams per meter cubed. That's nearly double the amount of moisture than we have in this box. That's why I've called this the Ultimate Filament Dry Box, because I can't find anything better, or even very close to the results I have here. That's why I'll be building more, so I can keep more of my filament rolls in them. Now, if you don't want to build more than one box, you can always use these vacuum bags to keep your rolls in between prints and then put them in the box for each print. You won't get the full advantage of sealing the reel in the box, but it's better than no box at all. Now, if you found anything better, whether it be a homemade option or even something commercially available, please drop a link in the comment below. I'd love to see figures of something that gets to a lower absolute humidity than we can get to with this dry box. Like you, I'm just trying to keep my filament as dry as possible so I get the best possible prints. Give me a like and click subscribe if you want to see more of this sort of thing. Thanks for watching.